left-hand side. Kelpies being a mythical creature in Scottish history and legend. Now, where they are situated is on either side of the Grand Canal, which goes all the way...
The old town started up where the castle is, which you'll see when we get into Princes Street. Started way back in the 6th century. Up on top of that volcanic plug, there was a little wooden fortress built there. Of course, we've heard of all that from. And it was quite a simple idea. It was a little grid system. And if you open your maps, you'll see the little grid system. It's three parallel streets. The three streets are known as Princess, George, and Queen. And that's where we're heading for now. We're going to take you around the new town and show you what was actually built to be back in 1767. And of course, most of the new town hall nowadays is shopping. All the department stores are actually in Princes Street. But all the buildings here in the new town are actually built from local sandstone. You can see the sandstone on both sides here. But notice how dirty and black our sandstone is. And the reason for that, of course, is coal. And of course, people say, why don't you clean your buildings up? Well, we did try to. If you look on your left there, you see the dirty black buildings, and look what happens when you clean it up on the right. But of course, after a couple of years, once you've cleaned the building up, a green mildew grows up on the buildings and starts to distort the look of the buildings. Oh my goodness, a tram car moving. This is a bugbear in Edinburgh, by the way. We only came into operation a year past May. £771 million for the tram from the airport to the city centre here. We didn't need trams, we got rid of them in 1956. They were a waste of time. But there's only the politicians who wanted the tram cars back in. And of course, the first 3 months they were open, they broke down six times. Because when a tram breaks down, you can't do anything. You've just got to, wait till they get it fixed and move it out at least in the city centre. 25 minutes. Tram. 36 minutes. Doesn't work. But this is actually just about in towards Princes Street now. Just when we go through the traffic lights along here, that's us onto Princes Street. Now, not all the buildings in Edinburgh are built from local sandstone, grey-coloured or cream-coloured sandstone. Some of the buildings in Edinburgh are built from red sandstone. And one of the largest red sandstone buildings is the Caledonian Hotel, or the Cali. Here it comes to your right. Sharp right. There it is. Suite bed and breakfast in that hotel, £470 a night.
Oh. Wow.
Yes, Trafalgar don't use it. Only people that can afford to use it, of course, are politicians and film stars. Now, do we have any Canadians on the coach, by the way?
Yeah.
Oh, we've got a few. Oh, that's good. Any Americans? Oh, just a couple. That's good. No fighting, by the way, guys. Got to prove something once and for all. This guy, but he is, he's a Scot. He wasn't actually working on a telephone when he came up with the idea. He was working on a hearing device for his wife. Here's his house here, the last blue door here. To the left of the door, you can see the plaque. You really swing left here. There you go, Alexander Graham Bell's birthplace. And this is Charlotte Square. Named after the wife of George III. Is this Charlotte as well? She looks a bit, she doesn't look as old as Charlotte that was named after. Remember, this is 1767 we're talking about. You don't look that age. In the centre of the gardens, we've got a statue of Prince Albert, the husband of Queen Victoria here. In the centre is Charlotte Square. And then, of course, all these buildings you can see round about here, this is all pure Georgian architecture. This is a Robert Adam design. He was one of the most famous architects, Scottish architects. And of course, the new town and old town of Edinburgh is a World Heritage Site. It's protected by UNESCO. And of course, the new town of Edinburgh has the largest amount of Georgian architecture collectively anywhere in the world. And of course, as we come round the corner, we're going to stop at number 6, the black door in front of that white van. Honestly, the white van, come here, please. And we'll have a look at this house. This is Bute House. Bute House, of course, the markers of Bute's old townhouse. It's now our official residence of our Prime Minister. This is the Scottish Prime Minister's house here. You can read the plaque on the lampstand there. Notice the security there for our Prime Minister?
None.
None, because we couldn't care less what happens to her. And she's not in residence anyway, her broomstick's not on the staircase. Just stop here, Graham. That's fine. Never mind the coach behind you, let him worry about that. Of course, you know that word politics is an English word. It's broken into two syllables. And when you break the word politics into two syllables, you come up with poly, which means many. If ticks means blood-sucking parasites. Sounds like politicians all over the world, doesn't it? Yeah. Now, you can't use that when you go back home. I've got the copyright. But if you look here as well, all the original features are still here. If you look at the bottom steps on your left-hand side, the metal boot scrapers were taking the mud off your feet in the old days. Mm-hmm. Because there was no roads or sidewalk. Yeah. It was all mud. So you scraped your boots before you went into the house. Then, look at the width of the doorways here. Why were the doorways built as wide as they are? And don't you dare say for fat Scotsmen. They were actually built like that for the old form of taxi we had here. The old form of taxi we used was a sedan chair. A sedan chair was a little box people would carry through the streets of Edinburgh in. It's the red door, and to the right of the red door as we stop, when we stop, you'll be able to read the inscription. His bedroom window was the second window directly above the red front door, by the way. There you go, Stevenson's house. Yeah, it's to stop you. Don't worry if anything comes round the corner behind you. We've got priority, we're here first. Now, Robert Louis Stevenson didn't just write beautiful novels. He wrote wonderful poetry as well. Actually, they followed her all the way to Monterey, California, where they eventually married her. And with his stepchildren, he rented a little yacht, set sail from San Francisco, headed all the way down through the Hawaiian Islands, all the way down to Australia. Straight up to the old town now, and then we're going to come back through the old town and visit, have a look at Holyrood Palace as well on the way through. Statue at the top of the hill, statue dedicated to George the Fourth. First king to come to Scotland over 100 years, came here in 1822. When he arrived here, he was wearing a red Royal Stuart tartan kilt, but a kilt is made to measure. This one only came halfway down his thigh. Have a look up as we pass. And underneath his kilt, he's wearing a pair of pink coloured tights. And you see the wrinkles at the knees back there as well. Yes. Of course, can you just picture him coming into Edinburgh by ship, walking down the gangplank, chubby guy, 5'6" tall, mini kilt and pink tights on. Well, all the ladies from Edinburgh started to laugh. And they made the Lord and Nurse rhyme up to him. And you all know the Nurse rhyme. It goes, George. It runs between George and Princess. That street is very important for you guys today, because there's 27 pubs in that street. Not for alcohol, for food. Food is all subsidised by the brewery. It's all home cooked, it's all great food. Don't go to a restaurant in Edinburgh. Restaurants are geared for tourists, okay? That's what the prices in the restaurants are extortionate. So that's why we always warn you until you go to the pubs. You get a main course in a pub for like £6 or £7. If you go to a restaurant,
well, it'll give
you
shopping. This gallery in front of us, Royal Scottish Academy. And there's the castle up to your right. But there's the Royal Scottish Academy there. That one you have to pay to go into.
But there is a lovely gallery just in behind it as we pass. Have a look. This is the Scottish National Gallery, full of Rembrandts, Monets, Degas, Titians, Scottish painters, English painters, free of charge. This building here on your left, there it's there. Beautiful building. And then of course, as we climb the hill here, I want you to look back to your left, behind the galleries, beautiful monument. This monument, you can see the top of it now, the largest monument to a literary figure anywhere in the world. This is the Sir Walter Scott Monument, or better known here locally as the Gothic Rocket, because of the shape of it. Yeah, Sir Walter Scott was born in the old town of Edinburgh in 1771, died in 1832. Then on your right, the dirty black building here, with the square towers on it, this is the College of Divinity. This is where all the church ministers were educated, in this building here. And then just in the gap coming up in the buildings, if you look in where the tree is here, the Writers' Museum, free of charge. That's in there. And then also on your left hand side, the old headquarters of the Bank of Scotland coming up here. This building's now a museum to banking. Get this, free of charge. A bank, unbelievable. But that's there to show you how they used to make the money in that building there. I don't know how many of the buildings are open today because this is a holiday. That happened. So no, the banks and the museums will be open, I assure you. You won't be disappointed going in there. There's been a church on that site since 1300. The original church is still there. Now, we're going to just slow down a bit. Just stop by the taxi here. Just for a minute, Graham. Because, you know, one that I've mentioned a couple of our famous writers,
used to pay the poor people
some money so they could operate on them, cut bits of the anatomy off. That was it. That's the Royal College there. Now, as we come down here, this is where you're going to see the little black onyx plaque where she wrote her Harry Potter stories. Nice and slow, just as we pass the scaffolding here, you'll see the black medicine coffee shop, the green shop. On the gable of the building here, there's the cafe spoon above, and you'll see the black onyx plaque just on the last section. Just have a look at it and you'll see what it says, J.K. Rowling. You see the effigy of her on that little onyx plaque there. That was the original coffee shop where she wrote her first book up there. On your left hand side, the old College of Edinburgh University. That building's 1791. That building is where the departments of history and law are. And that's where I did my Scottish history, in that building there. The street I was talking about closed is on the left hand side here. You'll see it as we pass. If anyone's interested in our National Museum of Scotland, you would have to come up to this street here where it's called. On the left hand side up there, past the scaffolding, that's the National Museum. Huge building. And we're going to turn right to the traffic lights down here, but look left and right, see how high up we are. Through the gap in the buildings. City's on two levels. The reason for that? Volcanic activity. That's the reason for it. And of course, this is where we rejoin the Royal Mile. The section up to your left, when we go turn right at the lights, that's the section where St. Giles is. We're not allowed to use that section. We're banned from using it as coaches. Yes, this is the shopkeepers that banned us, because they say people on coaches don't go into the shops to buy anything. And that's why they banned us for going up there. And as we turn, the building on the right-hand side here, the Radisson Blue Hotel, another building in this section of the Royal Mile, the oldest building in the Royal Mile, is coming up on your left. In a moment, in the corner down here, well, it's a little bit of a traffic jam here, there is a building right in the corner. It's got Cashmere and Kilt Centre on it. This house dates to the year 1470. It's called Mowbray House, and jutting out from it is John Knox's house. The Presbyterian reformer died in this house in 1572. What a place to park. Oh, the bus on the right hand side there. He's blocking everything. Look here on your left, you'll see in the corner, that's the oldest house lived in, 1470. And then John Knox's house jutting out into the street here. There you go, that's it, Mowbray House. Now, between here and Edinburgh Castle, 20,000 people live in this one single street. Just here at the traffic lights is where the city gate used to stand. And of course, they knocked the city gate down in 1865 because they appointed the first medical officer of health back then. His name was Dr. Henry Littlejohn, and he saw the plague and disease up here in the old town. Once they knocked the city gate down, what they did, the average age of a lady back then was only 27, the average age of a man was 35. Nowadays it's completely changed. The average age of a man now is 77, I've got a couple of years left, and the average age of a lady is 82 here in Edinburgh. And this section of the Royal Mile is called the Cannon Gate. Now we're going to actually go down to the palace, and we're going to stop at Holyrood Palace for a moment, because I'm going to let you use the restrooms down here. Because the time you would need the restroom stop before we carry on with the rest. Now this is a teacher training college, part of Edinburgh University. And then coming up on the left hand side in a moment, a lovely little church, just where the trees are here. This is the Canongate Kirk, 1688. This is the church the Queen's granddaughter was married in 3 years ago. This is where Zara Phillips was married, Princess Anne's daughter. In there. And she was only getting her own back on her mother. You know her mother's the patron of Scottish rugby. And Princess Anne decided to marry the captain of the English rugby team here in Edinburgh. She was just rubbing her mother's nose in it, that's all it was. And then, of course, on the right-hand side coming up, we have little one of our little primary schools here. Primary education became compulsory here in 1874, and that's the style of schools they built back then. On your left, the white building to the front left, that is the Earls of Winton's townhouse, Whiteford House, used for the old soldiers when they retired from the army. Into your right, the cream-painted building here, the Marquess of Queensbury's old townhouse. And it was the first Marquess of Queensbury who gave us the rules to boxing. That's where he lived. Now, we're going round to the left here, and we're going to go around to the coach park. And then when we get round here, I want you to come off the coach, and we'll walk across a little path to the front of the palace.
So as you heard, we're in Edinburgh, and we're just taking a restroom break. And then I don't know what we're going to do next, but this is what we're walking past on the way to the restroom. There's the castle right through there.
Once a year, when she needs to not have a bath, don't laugh. It's more than a half cousin England ever did. Elizabeth I said to have never bathed. That's why she was known as the Virgin Queen. Look, there's the plaque there. The blue plaque tells you on there, Queen Mary's Bathhouse. Everybody thinks you're telling lies, but that's what it was. And of course, for the Americans on the coach, well, a couple, mind you. Look at this white building here on the left. You thought about it in 1970. We've had it here since the 15th century. It's the Watergate. That's where the cookhouse in Wells were that supplied the food and water to the palace of Holyrood House. Into your left, the two towers there, that's the oldest part of the palace, 1498. Of course,
it's
it all started
Queen's
down
palace
here on the left.
Gate that we
and,
just
and
looked
there
at.
There was a ruined abbey now. The abbey dates to 1128. But coming up here on the left-hand side, this low building just in a moment, this is what we call the Royal Mews. This is the stables of the palace. And of course, just about 3 weeks ago, Charles was here. He was staying in the palace, his other half was staying in there. You think Charles needed well? We could even call it the Palace Hotel. The Queen only comes here for 6 days a year, but everybody else comes here to stay as well. And of course, when the Queen is here, she holds a garden party in the palace gardens, and she invites 6,000 people from the city of Edinburgh to her garden party. So as we come round the corner, looking over the wall there, where they're cutting the grass, now you're getting the same view of the garden party as I get. Because all the years she's been on the throne, I have never been invited. Yeah. Of course, they're getting it ready now, because she'll be here with Oliver Cromwell in 1650, the famous Englishman. Now I can stand up again. Past the Parliament. I'll tell you about the Parliament when we go back round anyway. But of course, look back to your left, you get a better view of the ruins of the Abbey there. The Queen's apartments are up beside the flagpole on the top floor there. That was the Queen's apartments. Going up to your right, they'll show you the other sides of Edinburgh as well. Just as coming up on the left, there's a gap coming up just shortly, just past to this gentleman's walking up. Well, I hope he's a gentleman. Look into your left here, you get a lovely view down. All depends how much mist is there, of course, because that's a sea mist that comes in every morning. See, it's still out there. There's the river out there. And that's Portobello down to your left there. Of course, that mist is called a sea har, spelt H-A-A-R. Comes in the morning, and then by about 10, 11 o'clock, it burns off and goes back out to the sea.
This is the female here. Watch her go for the bread.
She's got it wagging its tail. It looks like a dog. So is that a male or a female?
That's the female. The male's over there.
Oh.
You see the big bump on the nose? That one's got a small one. But you see the size the male is? It's a huge one.
Yeah. Look at the gulls.
Well, the gulls are terrible here, yeah. Actually, just round the corner, the little raft in the middle of the lock's just round the corner. We'll see it when we go round.
As I told you, I'm a silversmith goldsmith. I made our wedding rings. And that was annoying, but they're still there because I checked the depth and I wouldn't go down. Yeah. There it's there on your left. There's the old 12th century church down there as well. That's Duddingston Lock. At the other side of the lock as we come along, you'll see the golf course here. This is one of 19 18-hole golf courses we have inside of City Burnbury. On the outskirts of the city, we have another 16 golf courses. 35 golf courses in and around the city of Edinburgh. Of course, you all know what the word golf means. You've been told, haven't you? Yeah. Ladies forbidden, yeah. You didn't want to see that bit, did you? But that's Prestonfield Golf Course at the left-hand side there. Beautiful golf course. This used to be an orchard, by the way. And of course, it was converted into a golf course. And you can actually see where it was an orchard, because as we come along, look at the fairways and look at the undulations in the fairways. This was the irrigation ditches when it was an orchard. And remember I told you about them cleaning up the Royal Mile with the 30 cap loads of sewage. This is where they dumped it all, on the orchard. This is where it was put. Just look over the edge as we come round. And you can actually see the ripples on the fairways. There you go, look at that. Beautiful golf course. How much would you think it would cost to play around the golf on that golf course? £36.
Wow.
That's all it costs. Golf is quite cheap here. It's only when you get to St Andrews that it's very expensive. But here it's very reasonably priced. Now the best view in Edinburgh, if the mist isn't covering it, is to the front of the coach. Keep looking to the front and you'll see Edinburgh Castle.
It's actually a beautiful day. Once it's burnt off, it's going to get up to
'Cause was covered in sheep and it destroyed most of the vegetation, and they moved the sheep off the hill and they started replanting all that beautiful Scottish broom. And in a couple of weeks' time that'll be gone, the yellow flower will be gone. On your left down the valley, these pinkish buildings down there, that's the halls of residence for the students of Edinburgh University. That's their accommodation. Edinburgh University is not the largest university in Scotland. It's not the oldest university, it's the largest. 23,500 students, 8,900 lecturers and professors at Edinburgh University. Now, on the right hand side as we come down, the rock formation here, this is known as Salisbury Crags.
Let's just run over them. You're supposed to use that cycle track on the right.
Let's see if you can get them, Graham. Go on. The bane of my life, cyclists. Oh. Police car in front of us. Look into your left there, it's there, there's the white porcupine. Just there. Dynamic Earth. Now, I'm going to plank myself down on the corner again because we're going back out and I'll just be a minute. Sorry about disturbing you. Now, I just don't want to get stopped by the police. Because Bridget will be annoyed if I'm late.
That
is the new Scottish Parliament. When it was built, it was supposed to cost us £42 million. It ended up costing us £431
million.
It is ugly, isn't it?
That's the one she said.
Spanish architect by the name of Enrique Morales was the man who designed that building. And
And the only thing he got right was, when we go round the corner and have a look, he put bars on the doors and the windows to keep the politicians in. And you'll actually see some of the wood is bent. That's the politicians trying to escape. And look at the security for our politicians. One policeman. One too many. Of course, it is ugly, isn't it? Well, that's politicians for you. They're the ones that decided it. Now, if you want to, you can come down, get a free souvenir, take part of the stonework away. We're desperate to get rid of it. It's terrible. Yeah, up to the right, you're grim. Well, the GS van, the G4S, yeah, that's the Group 4 Security. Now, I can stand up now, I'm way past the policeman now. And then, of course, into the right is your palace. The two old towers you see through to your right, that's where Mary Queen of Scots lived when she came here from France in 1561. And as we climb the hill, we're going underneath the railway bridge in a minute. This is the main line between Edinburgh and London. Train from London to Edinburgh now is only 4.5 hours. It's all electrified, you can see it up there. Of course, that's the best thing that ever came out of London, was a train to Scotland. He's going to hit that brake one of these days. Then look to your right, you get a view of the ancient volcano. See the mist right at the very top? Then, of course, as we come up here, beautiful building coming up on the right hand side in a moment or two. It designed as the Temple of... That's old Royal Mile School, the Royal High School for Boys. On the right hand side, the monument up there on the top of the hill, on Calton Hill, that's the monument to Admiral Lord Nelson. It's in the shape of an upturned telescope. That's one of the seven hills that Edinburgh is built on. The hills of Edinburgh is quite easy, it's ABC. Arthur's Seat was the main one. Then you've got Blackford Hill, Braid Hills, then you've got Calton Hill, Castle Hill, you've got Craig Lockhart Hill as well. So that's how you remember the seven hills of Edinburgh. Now, the building on the left here, this is St Andrew's House, the Scottish office, built in 1939, full of politicians, and this building is built on the site of the old city jail. You should have just left the city jail up there for the politicians. Been a fitting tribute to them. Now, before I finish, this is where we finish, just round the corner here. This is Waterloo Place. If you get your little maps out and look at the end of Princess Street, you'll see this street saying Waterloo Place. It's literally a continuation of Princess Street, because directly ahead of us, when we go round the corner, you'll see...
Okay, we just got off the bus, and our tour guide was great. And so now we're gonna go see the castle first, because we've been told that from where we were dropped off, that it's an easier walk to go to see it from here where we are than to try to walk back up, because it's a hill, and apparently it's a bigger hill if you go a different direction. But we're gonna try to see as many of the historic buildings as we can, get lots of pictures, because I honestly had no idea how... Oh my goodness, we're going way over there? I honestly had no idea how many historic buildings there were here. Truly, did you? Or how beautiful they were. Okay, this is Adam Smith. I don't know who Adam Smith is, but that's Adam Smith.
That's him.
That's him. This is a beautiful church. I don't know what church it is, but it's beautiful.
Yeah, it's the inside.
He said make sure you don't miss one of them, to make sure you go inside. He said, I bet that's the one that he said not to miss. It's beautiful.
This is open. Do you want to go in?
I wonder if you have to pay. £2. So we bought a photo pass and they give you a sticker. It was only £2. So to me that's absolutely worth it. right there.
Do you want to go in there?
We can. They've been about the same thing, you know? I don't mind if we walk back out if you know where we're going. But if you want to go in the gift shop, we will. So that was St. Giles's Cathedral. And it's, yeah, I just said it's St. Giles or Giles. Yeah, St. Giles's Cathedral. And I, once again, totally worth the £2 to be able to take pictures. And hopefully I did a good job because Kevin let me, one last shot of the organ. Kevin let me take the pictures this time because we only bought one photo pass. And that was me because he knows that I'm going to vlog it.
Yeah, you're going to video
it
anyway.
I'm gonna vlog it. I might as well take the pictures as well. So we've left the cathedral and we're back out on the street. And it's pretty busy, but it is a bank holiday, so a lot of people have the day off.
But we're spring. Did she call it the spring bank holiday or the summer?
I don't know. Spring. They must sell crunchy bars or something those summer over there because there's a sign. We come in like an indoor shopping mall and it's like five floors. So we've been in a lot of these shops, but they're so close. There's not enough room to move. So I have not filmed anything. This is Edinburgh Castle and we will not be going through it because I think she said it was £16.50 each.
It takes a long time.
Yeah, we wouldn't have time to properly appreciate the castle and get to look at anything else at all. So, but we wanted to at least make our way up here to look at it and get some pictures of the outside of it for you. So we're standing on the edge of the castle right here, and if you come over to the side here, you can see the city.
A lot of buses.
Yes, there are a lot of buses down there. Thank you. kind of hard to see the statues because it's a dark day.
Yeah.
It's a dark, overcast day, and we're trying to take pictures of dark monuments. So there is the back of the castle, and it's absolutely massive. So when we walked up on it a while ago, you were not seeing near the how huge it is, the expanse of it, because it's absolutely it goes out in all directions and like covers the top of that hill. That would have been a better one. Yeah, look. See how big that is? They have an anthropology, moss, Trotters, opticians. There's all kinds of stores here. The good thing is that the sidewalks are wider, so you have more room to walk, and this street isn't as busy. We're still on the same street, we're just further down. Yeah. We saw a huge Hollister.
Yeah, it was like 2-4.
Yeah, two-story Hollister. Massive. Bigger than in any mall I've ever seen in the United States. But if you're gonna bring it, yeah, if you're gonna bring it overseas, you might as well bring it all, huh? View of the castle. We've just we've walked on around, and that's just another view. Somebody's coming. There's the slug and lettuce.
Pretty sure it's across the street, so if you want to cross.
Okay. Today we're going to be having lunch in Edinburgh, Scotland, in GBK. It is a gourmet burger kitchen. I'm back by the Hollister, so I wanted to show it to you because I commented that it was so big.
It's actually brief.
It's right over there.
There's a garbage bin up here.
So, we've eaten lunch. And that will be in a separate review all of its own. We also, Oh, there's the castle. I didn't even know. I was looking over here. If we kept going that way, I would have missed the castle. Okay, what street are we on?
Frederick Street, and I don't know what the cross street is.
Yeah, that's where we're at. So if you...
We're on the castle side of Frederick Street.
Yeah, if you see this statue, you need to stop here and...
This is the best view we've seen.
Yes, because we went all the way up to the castle, and you don't know how big it is.
It is like a medieval town.
It's a town. It's enormous.
That would take you all day to walk.
Yeah, I know. That's why we didn't get to go. That's why... There's a Primark. Primark. That's why we did not even try to go. It's a Primark. That whole building is a Primark. Maybe they're redoing the windows. Would you like me to carry a bag?
Good for now.
So what I said was that after we ate lunch, that will be in a separate review. And then we bought this ice cream and we reviewed that on the street. And so that's the second time we've done that on our trip over here. And it's actually been fun. And you just have to have the attitude that you don't know these people. They're never going to see you again. And ultimately, what does it matter, you know?
It's not illegal.
You're not doing anything wrong. So, doesn't matter. Look at that garden down there. British Home Stores. Wonder what that has in it. If you've ever bought anything from British Home Stores, is it like a Macy's or is it like a, what would it be like? I was saying if you've ever bought anything from the Great British Home Store, it's over there. Let me know if it's like a Macy's or something. There's Marks and Spencer. Full-size Marks and Spencer, and Kevin had me go in the co-op instead. So there's Marks and Spencer. Honestly, I don't see the grocery side of it. So the grocery store is probably in the back of it, or this could be one of the ones that's just a clothing store. Maybe this one isn't. No, they have a food one. Right in the middle, there's the food section. So...
The next street we can go.
Okay.
The birds are always sitting on their heads.
Yeah. What did you say the man called this? Yeah, but he called it.
Gothic Rocket.
The Gothic Rocket is what the tour guide called it.
I think that's what he called it. Something Rocket. I'm pretty sure it was Gothic.
The Scott Monument, Sir Walter Scott. From that street way down there, all the way up here, and I did not show you because I just didn't think about doing it because we were breathing heavy. And now we're going all the way up these steps. Now, you just have to take it one at a time.
These steps are actually worn. How many people are
worn? Yeah, they're very worn.
They
do. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Yeah. So way down there is where we came on that main street. Yeah. There's a lot of these passages around here that lead behind the main buildings to make it quicker to get around because you don't have to fight the crowds. You see, no one was back here. You can't breathe, but you're here.
That's all that matters. I'm not breathing. It's gone.
So we've gone in a few shops. Like I said, I don't know if you heard me. I have not been filming here like I did in London at all, because these shops are so much smaller. I don't know why they are, but they just are. They're much, much smaller, and there's not enough room to swing a cat in some of these places. There's some person's pants. Yeah, okay, so remember all those steps that we walked up earlier? Now we're walking up these because Kevin has a death wish. There's it looks
I wasn't that one.
Yes. That was horrible. When we get to the top, I'm gonna show you what it looks like. It smells like pizza. Okay, I'm gonna show you way down there. Like the steps were like way down there. Okay, right. are seeing the biggest rabbit we've ever seen. Oh my gosh. That is a huge rabbit. Wow. That was awesome. That was so awesome. We went back to the room. The wind is going to be horrible, but we went back to the room. And so there is a BP station at the end, like probably a mile away. So we've decided to walk down here to see what they have, because we're in the room early. Everyone else, well, not everyone else, the people, some people chose to go out to a dinner tonight to pay.
In the station, and I completely forgot to tell, honestly. They probably would have looked at me funny because it was a really small place, but it's like a, honestly, it's like a speedway in the United States, yeah, because it had a subway inside of there. Yeah. Now, what I want to say right now.
But they didn't have roller food.
They didn't have what?
Roller food.
Oh, like hot dogs on a roller.
Yeah.
Wizard fingers. Yeah, they didn't have any of that kind of food, but they did have a Subway. So what I want to say right here, before I forget, is I don't know why she hasn't recommended to the people on the tour, if you don't want to go on the excursions, we were here at this castle for two nights, last night and tonight. If you weren't going on the excursion, instead of spending all this money for dinner at the castle, which some people may have done, you could walk down to that place and get a Subway sandwich for like $5, yeah, or something.
And work off some calories.
Yeah, I mean, truly. Or they sell the boxed sandwiches, just like Tesco and all of those places. You know, you get the box sandwiches. They sell those in there as well. So you could have gotten a sandwich, a bag of chips, your choice.
For two people for less than 10 pounds.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know why she hasn't recommended that. It just boggles my mind. But anyway, we did buy some stuff. They actually had what I went in there for. So I'm thrilled. I'm just thrilled to death. So I'm gonna add it to my ever-increasing grocery haul. That will probably be the longest grocery haul ever. But it's 2 weeks worth in London. Instead of you all seeing a haul a week at home, you're basically seeing 2 weeks. So it should be longer, right? So anyway, I just wanted to throw that out there because I thought it was weird that, you know, most people love Subway, and she just never brought that up. So we're on our way back now. I'm hoping I see another rabbit again, because that was pretty exciting. And it was a weird color too. It was like a red rabbit. Like you see those red squirrels? It was a red rabbit. Oh, did you think it looked brown?
Yeah, it's a red. It's a red.